Hi guys, welcome back to another DJF video review. Today I'll be checking out this new laptop cooler from Thermaltake. It's the Massive SP. It's got integrated speakers, which is pretty sweet. I've never seen a laptop cooler before with speakers in it. It's also got USB ports as well. It's got a 140mm LED fan. You can also adjust the speed of that as well. I think you can change the LED on and off. We'll have a look at that. And it supports laptop sizes up to 17 inches. So we'll have a look on the back because there's a fair bit of information on there. We'll just zoom in a bit. Okay, so these are the shots up here with the integrated dual speakers. So there's one either side. You've got your quiet 140mm fan there, USB ports as well, and that also acts as a switch as well, I believe. We'll go into that, a power switch for the speaker and the LED. So we can look at that, and we'll go over to the left and see what's over here. Okay, so let's make sure we can see all that. So the weight of this is 950 grams, so it's not too heavy. It's black, it's mesh and plastic. The fan speed is 800 to 1300 RPM, 29 decibels, that's going to be pretty quiet. 54 CFM. I'm just going to see if it tells you anything about the speaker. No, it doesn't really tell you anything about the speaker, but we'll have a look and see how that sounds later on. I'll just zoom out, we'll just have a look what's inside. And oh, there's another shot on the cables as well. So you get a standard 3.5mm audio cable and a USB cable for the power, which would plug into your laptop as well. Just open it up. Alrighty, so that comes in the box like that. We'll see what other bits we get. Bit of a quick start manual with the, it's going to be hard to read, with the warranty card as well over here. And it just tells you sort of the cables and what to do and things like that. But it'll be pretty straightforward. Now it's had this little box here. I believe this may not be released yet, so I don't have a price on this product yet. Okay, so there's your audio cable plugged straight into your laptop, 3.5mm. They're not gold plated, but that's probably not too much of a concern. And this is your USB cable. So it's going to be two USB into your laptop. Like, that is a few, but I guess you're only going to need the secondary USB to go on your laptop if you want to power a device from this laptop cooler. So here's the cooler itself. I'll just get rid of this noisy plastic. We'll start underneath. So that's there, pretty basic underneath, just the model. And you can see the fan. I'll also turn this on and tick as well. And that's what it looks like from front on. Nice mesh design, and you just got the Thermaltake logo there. Some rubber pads there for when your laptop's on, so it won't slide off or anything. Okay, the left side. It might be hard to see that, but that is a symbol of the fan and on and off. So that's just a simple... Okay, cool. So that's off. Then when you turn it, that's on. And then when you move it up, that's your speed. So there's your speed down, and it turns it off, on, speed up. So that's pretty cool. And you can just see the speaker in there. So that looks like a fair decent size. We'll test it out. It might be hard to get the sound going through this mic, but you'll be able to see. Okay, and then on the other side, which is really sweet, same design. So we've got speaker, on or off. And then it just looks like you control the volume through your laptop. And moving over, we've got the audio in for the speakers, so that'll be going from your laptop. I guess you could even plug an iPod into these or something, because they'll sound much better than headphones. You've got your LED on and off, so it's good that you can control the LED, because that LED might be quite bright. We'll see what that looks like in a bit. And then your two USB, so there's this USB 2.0, as it says there. You might just be able to see that, not 3. You probably don't really need 3. I'll grab my laptop out now, we'll fire this up and see how noisy it is and see how the speakers sound and see how the LED looks. Alright, so I'll hook it up now. Pretty straightforward. You plug your audio cable that goes from your laptop into there. You plug your USB that goes from your laptop into here, and I'll also just plug in a mouse just to show you that you can also power a mouse as well. So that's it all there. Currently it is set to off. That's why nothing is on. I'll just zoom out a bit. Like that. So if I just turn the fan on, I'll put it on full ball. So that's full ball. I'll put this around and I pretty much can just hear that from here. So that's really quiet. And then on this side, we can hit the LED button. Like that. It's not really too bright. You don't really want a massive bright light, but it's just there to add a bit of bling as well. Then over on this side here, we have the speaker, so I can turn the speaker on. So there's no real speaker volume, you just do that with your laptop. So what I might do is actually I might unplug the speaker and show you what it sounds like out of my laptop. I'll just go over to my laptop. Now my laptop does have Beats Audio, which is pretty good for a laptop. I might just keep this still pinned on my shirt with the mic, just to keep it even. I'll make sure that's down a bit. So that's on my laptop. It's probably going to be hard to get that to come in through that mic. So pretty standard for a laptop. Definitely doesn't really sound that good. And these are meant to be pretty good speakers in here, so. Alright, so I'll pause that. I'll go back a bit to where it was. Now, I'll plug it into the... plug it into the laptop stand over there. Just move that over a bit there. And now we'll see what this sounds like. I'll just go back a bit. So you got so much more volume. Now I guess I can just switch it. So the laptop is just so dull. And I actually thought this laptop was good. And then if I want to really crank it up, so I'm actually really surprised at how that sounds. The bass is really, really good. What I'll do is I'll actually put my laptop on it just to see how it... So yeah, as you can see, I think my laptop is 14 point something, maybe 15. I actually haven't looked. I can't remember what size my laptop is, but you can see that fits on there quite nicely like that. Just covers it. And with that fan coming on, this laptop runs super cool now. Sometimes I am lazy and I do some rendering on this laptop and it gets really, really hot. But with this on it, even just sort of raising a laptop off, one of the worst things for laptops is if you're on a bed or you're on a couch, if you have this sitting on a couch, it just suffocates it. You've got all your vents underneath and it tries to exhaust it out the side and it just does no good for your laptop. So even just raising it off the ground is good, but having the fan on it as well just makes it so much cooler. And also love the idea with the speakers, really, really good. The USB port I guess is handy. It makes it an all-in-one unit. It'd just be interesting to see how much this costs when it comes out, but I don't think it'll be too much. I think it'd be worth getting the speakers on it, even if you just plugged in your iPod or something like that as well. And to have the fan control on it and the speakers on that side makes it really, really great. So that's pretty much it for this review. Just wanted to show you how the sounds, what it looks like, and sort of the new features on this. So thanks to Thermaltake for sending this out. I might add this at the next UGF on display. It just depends where it'll be and things like that. But yeah, thanks to Thermaltake for sending this out, and stay tuned for more videos in the future.